Uncle Gutenberg was a bookworm, and he lived on Charing Cross. The memory of his volumes brings a smile. He would read me lots of stories when he wasn't on the source. Now I'd like to share the wisdom of my favorite bibliophile. He said, cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook. Chapter titles are like signs, and if you read between the lines, you'll find your first impression was mistook. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Mary Poppins, could you give us an example?
Certainly. Nellie Rubina was made of wood, but what could not be seen was though her trunk up top was barren, well her roots were lush and green. So in spring when Mr. Hickory saw her blossoms blooming there, he took root despite her bark, and now there's seedlings everywhere. Which proves a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook.
Chapter titles are like signs,
and if you read between the lines, you'll find your first impression was mistook. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Shall we do the one about the wealthy widow?
Oh, by all means.
Always loved that one.
Well, go on then.
Lady Hyacinth McCaw brought all her treasures to a reef,
where she only wore a smile,
plus two feathers and a leaf.
So no one tried to rob her, cause she barely wore a stitch.
For when you're in your birthday suit, there ain't much there to show you're rich. Oh, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook. Ta-ru-ra-lee, ta-ru-ra-la, ta-ru-ra-lee, ta-ra-ta-ta. You'll find your first impression was mistook. Ya-da-da-da. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Oh, give us the one about the dirty rascal, why don't you?
Isn't that one a bit long?
Well, the quicker you're into it, the quicker you're out of it.
Once upon a time in a nursery rhyme, there was a castle with a king hiding in a wing. Cos he never went to school to learn a single thing. He had sceptres and swords and a parliament of lords, but on the inside he was sad, egad, because he never had a wisdom for numbers, a wisdom for words. Though his crown was quite immense, his brain was smaller than a bird's. So the queen of the nation made a royal proclamation to the misses and the messers, the more or lessers, bring me all the land's professors. Then she went to the hairdressers, and they came from the east, and they came from the south. From each college they put knowledge from their brains into his mouth. But the king couldn't learn, so each professor met their fate, for the queen had their heads removed and placed upon the gate. And on that date, I stayed their wives, I got a note, their mate was now the late great. But then suddenly one day a stranger started in to sing. He said, I'm the dirty rascal and I'm here to teach the king. And the queen clutched the jewels, for she hated royal fools. But this fool had some rules they really ought to teach in schools. Like, you'll be a happy king if you enjoy the things you've got. You should never try to be the kind of person that you're not. So they sang and they laughed, for the king had found a friend. And they ran onto a rainbow for the story's perfect end. So the moral is, you mustn't let the outside be the guide, for it's not so cut and dried. Well, unless it's Dr. Jekyll, then you better hide. Petrified! No, the truth can't be denied. As I now have testified, all that really counts and matters is the special stuff inside. Oh, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook.
So please listen to what we've said
and open a book tonight in bed. So one more time before we get the hook, sing it out strong.
A cover is nice.
Please take her advice.
A cover is nice.
Or you'll pay the price.
A cover is nice.